looks like I'm going back to my roots. I'm out. Hey guys, what's up? It's your girl, Lucky Mommy. We're back with another video.
Yeah, I just recently lost a lot of weight due to stress and a little bit of depression, but anxiety. I forgot to tell y'all too. I got diagnosed with anxiety and depression. I knew I wasn't crazy. So I was like, it happens too much for me not to be diagnosed with it. You feel what I'm saying? So how we like the makeup today? She looks good. What I mean by going back to my roots, I'm starting at another fucking, I don't even want to tell you what it is. Like, what the fuck? But I'm starting back at my roots where I'm loved and enjoyed because I work so much and I work so hard. You know what I'm saying? What can I say? It just always draws me back. It always pulls me back. And I'm like, and they're like, yeah, come back. And I'm like, do I want to? Fuck it, y'all show me love. Y'all show me love before, so let's go back to it. You know, I don't like a lot of like candy and stuff like that. But I will drink me a drink down, okay? You can give me a drink over food any day, and I'll be suffice. Lately, though, let me tell y'all a little bit more about my health, because my health's been real bad. I've been having fainting spells, okay? And that spells like magic and witches and stuff like that. I don't mess with none of that. We with the Lord over here, you feel what I'm saying? And if you don't believe in that, I apologize. I ain't got nothing to say about it, you feel what I'm saying? Obviously, I have to go to the doctor, see what's going on. I've been really getting into my health era, you know what I mean? Since last year, I've been by myself, as you guys know. I'm not really one to boast if I'm in a relationship or single, but this year is making 2 years in December that I've been single. I've been getting myself right, going to the doctor, getting all questions asked, everything checked out, so we're all good over here. You know, we're just really getting ourselves together slowly but surely. If you know me from back in the day, right, if you know me from back in the day, you know that I was not one of them. I was not going to the hospital. You couldn't pay me to go to the hospital. That's how bad it was. Like, I was so traumatized by the hospital because this very close person to me always had to go to the hospital. Long story short, she always went to the hospital, okay? And it was like the hospital wasn't helping figure out or get a resolution to what was going on. And there was multiple things going on, you feel what I'm saying? And I think that, because I was a part of what she went through, it just kind of traumatized me a little bit, to the point I was like, yeah, I'm not going to the hospital for nothing. I don't care if I'm sick, I'm staying home, blah 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 blah. But yeah, I used to be very anti-hospital. Like, I was, for myself, I should say that, for myself. If you chose to go to the hospital because you wanted to get checked out, body wise, health wise, whatever, that's up to you. I never was like, oh, you shouldn't go to the hospital. I've never told nobody that, okay? I did not tell nobody that. Me myself personally, because of stuff that I've been through, I just was not very trusting into the hospitals. I felt like, you know, and I'm speaking from somebody who wants to be in the medical field for multiple reasons. Number one reason being a pediatrician, because I love kids. Kids kind of gravitate towards me. So I wanted to be like another outlet for them, but health wise. So then I also wanted to be a teacher. So just imagine how much I loved kids. Although I did not want children of my own, I just liked how everybody else's kid was gravitating towards me. But then obviously I ended up pregnant, got with this man. We ain't gonna speak too much on him because he's irrelevant. I'm not. Okay, again, this is for me, not you. You feel what I'm saying? I'm not speaking to you saying, oh, da da da. I'm just not a abortion type of person, okay? So I've always said, if I got pregnant by whoever I was with, not getting rid of the baby, you feel what I'm saying? If they choose not to help out, or they choose not to want to be around because they didn't want the child, then that's up to them, which that's not what happened. Let me just say that right now. But yeah, anyways, fast forward. I ended up having a child of my own, and man, I ain't gonna lie, I did not want her to witness a lot of things that happened with us as a whole, like, because me and my daughter, we are one. Literally just, we're one. She did bring a lot of light in my life. I was going through a really bad state where I was getting, I don't even want to know what I have, but let me tell you, I literally went through a stage in my life where I was down bad. I was truly down bad. Like, I was smoking heavy again. I was around people who were smoking heavy every day, hitting a blunt. Wake up, hit the blunt. To the time you go to bed, hit the blunt. You feel what I'm saying? And I was around those people for so long that I got back into my habits of smoking and hitting that blunt. You feel what I'm saying? But I have not been smoking. I think one of the reasons is because, again, I was traumatized again. Poor little old me. I was just traumatized all over again. My incident happened and I just stopped smoking altogether. I cut myself cold turkey. It wasn't no like, oh, let me hit the blunt. No, it was none of that. None of that. I'm a strong individual. I know how to say no to certain cravings and stuff like that. So it's not something like I can be like, oh, I relapsed. No. Now I'm only around lesser people who still smokes to this day. And I'm not tempted. I'm not like, oh, let me hit that. Oh, let me hit it one time. No. No, I have not been, you know, smoking. I'm not saying it's bad for you or good for you. I'm just talking about my journey and personal. But yeah, I just, you know, stopped a lot of things that I was doing back then. I think a lot of it had to do with my child. My child really switched me in a different light and different paths. I've been through struggle, okay? We all go through struggles in life, and I go through a lot of struggles in life because I have to be the toughest soldier over here. And it's just, you know, but I'm not here to preach to y'all and tell y'all to start doing this and stop doing that. No, this is just me personally and what I've been through. If you can relate, you can relate. And if you can't, you just can't. It doesn't make you a good or bad person for relating or not relating, or seeing where I'm coming from or seeing where I'm not coming from. You feel what I'm saying? I'm still struggling, okay? And not with smoking habits, okay? But yeah, I'm just saying, in general, I struggle with a lot of stuff mentally, and on top of my anxiety is the worst struggle to have for me. Not saying any other sickness is not the worst. They're all, you know, they all have their cons and pros, but anxiety for me is so limiting. I'm really not able to do the good stuff I used to do back then. And I know I gotta stop looking in the past to what was good and what wasn't good for me, because, you know, it's over with now. It happened already. It's done. I just kind of figure that just keep moving forward with life. Good things will happen to me, and good things will keep happening to me. But lately, I'm not gonna lie, it hasn't been as bad, because, you know, God's shown a little light towards my way for a lot of stuff. Still keeping that present in my life. But yeah, let me just tell you a little bit more. My child, yes, like I said, I've been by myself with my child. It is now going on the second year, technically third in my belly. With her being in my belly, that's what I meant to say. Yeah, it's just been us. Haven't been in contact, or trying to contact, or trying to reach out, and I haven't been trying to do that. And I haven't spoke on the situation, because the situation is terrible, to say the least. And plus, there's just so many people who have it out for me for God knows the reason, because I don't. But I have not tried to provoke them in this time being, because what would be the point of that? It's just drama, and it's just negativity that's attached to it, and not anything good that's gonna come from it. And I understand watching this video is just gonna make them want to. And you might be like, oh, why would you think that they watch your, they told me, you feel what I'm saying? They told me, I don't know what's going on over there. What he, she, they are doing. That's not a part of me. Okay. It's not a part of my child. My child's doing great. She's learning new stuff every freaking day. I am so happy to be a mom. Am I struggling because I'm by myself? Of course. Now, I would be struggling if I wasn't by myself, you know what I mean? But I've been doing this thing. I've been doing the motherfucking mom thing, you know what I'm saying? So, I just wanted to make y'all a serious video, saying limited jokes as possible, so y'all understand a little bit more in my life, because this is my documentary. My whole channel is my documentary of my life and what I've been through, what I haven't been through, stuff that I can talk on, because I've been through certain situations like that, you feel what I'm saying? But yeah, you know, no negativity coming from over here, just all positive life. If you have anything bad to say about me or to me or towards me, God bless you, and that's all I can say. But again, if you don't believe in God, then something shed goodness your way. I don't know, something shed some positivity your way, positivity your way or something. I don't know what to tell you. For the longest, I wanted to speak on a situation that happened between my child's father and myself and certain parties that was involved. I haven't talked about it. I probably won't talk about it because, again, it'll just bring negativity. And it's not like negativity is not gonna ever show its face again. Negativity always shows its face. It always does. It always does. And, you know, sometimes you just mentally are prepared for it, and sometimes you're not. But now, all I can say for sure is that I have nothing to say on the situation. I want to talk about it with you guys only because this is my life on here. This is my truth of my entirety being on here. Like, I've talked to y'all about exes. I've talked to y'all about people I was with. I've talked to y'all about friends. I've talked to y'all about family. And not talk about, talk to y'all about situations I've been through. And the situations I've been through are no joke. Those are dead ass. Because if you feel like I'm lying, and say you were the other person, like say I was talking about trash can for some reason, you know what I mean? Because it's right in front of me. But say I was talking about trash can, and you felt like trash can was you because you was involved with my life before. And you somehow watch my videos or something like that, and you feel like saying, oh, she's lying. I have no reason to lie to my YouTube channel, bro. I have no reason to make up lies. You act like the whole city and town is watching my shit. No, they're not. It's just you. It's just you. It really is just you. There's a lot of stuff that got me to a point of trauma blocking. And I don't think a lot of people talk about their traumas a lot, and I do. You know, I do kind of trauma dump on people, especially if, you know, we're friends and or we become friends because I trauma dumped on you. You know what I mean? I do apologize to all the good friends I did have in my life, and we just stopped talking. Not because you did something or I did something or somebody did something for us to stop talking to each other. It's always a reason for something. I'm really forgetful when it comes to stuff because, again, when you trauma block something or something really, really, really traumatic happened to you, a lot of good stuff or even slightly bad stuff that's happened to you, you kind of like shut it away. You feel what I'm saying? And there's a lot of stuff that I'd be like, huh, what did I just tell you? I truthfully forgot. It's not like, oh, she just want to make sure I'm listening or something. Like, no, like I deadass forgot. Like, I haven't really talked about me being a mom for real on here. And the mom life is testing a lot of stuff, patience, but patience is a virtue, you feel what I'm saying? And I'm literally learning that more and more, because if I didn't have patience before, I'm definitely trying to have it, you feel what I'm saying? She's a busybody, now, and she's into everything. She wants to take, like, say I just cleaned the closet up and I put everything away. She want to go back in the closet and tear everything out, like, right after I did it, or as I'm doing it. But I love her so much. That's, like, my whole life in one person. And I thought being with somebody, having a partner, that would be my whole person. No, my child is my whole world in a person. If anything ever was to happen to my child, I probably wouldn't be here no more. Not even probably, I would not be here no more. I always knew I could be a mom. You feel what I'm saying? It was never no doubt in being a mom. Like, I've been a mom before I was a mom. The mom life is, it's definitely, it's amazing. It's fascinating. And it's beautiful. Do you get angry? Yeah. But do you take it out on your child? Do you take it out on your child? No. The fuck? I feel like some people are just twisted in the head. And my baby's a toddler now. She's literally gonna be 2 in October. My little pumpkin butt. I love her so much, y'all. Y'all don't understand. The love is like out of this world. I feel like love is unexplainable. I feel like love is timeless. You feel what I'm saying? There's no start and end, or it might be even a start to it, but I don't think it's an end to love. You feel what I'm saying? But it's definitely not something that just goes away quickly. Bye. I love you guys to bits and pieces. I'll see you guys later. Bye. Ciao.